What's up guys, Josh Antolin here, and today we are going to check on some tips when traveling to Maldives. We are currently here in the Barros Maldives, which is one of the luxury resorts here in the Maldives. As you can see, in my background is so nice. There's a pool here. We are in the ocean pool villa, so we are on top of the ocean, the Indian Ocean. So it's really nice here. Disclaimer, I am by no means an expert in travel or whatever. I am just telling this for my own experience, and I would like to share it with you so that you can think of a better way or guide through your travel. Let's go to some quick tips. Quick tip number one, do your research. It may seem obvious, but there's a lot more to research on. So I divided it into four categories. Number one is when. When is the best time or best season when traveling to Maldives? Today is September 27, and it's actually the start of the peak season. The peak season is at around December, which there will be a lot of people, but I guess the scenery is even better than now. But September, I think it's quite nice already, because out of the 6-7 days that we're here, it only rained once, but it's just fast rain and it's done already in a few minutes. Next is what airline. Maybe there's a promo airline, or what to do and what is the purpose of your trip. It could be for leisure, luxury, or just travel experience. It will all boil down, or it will all roam around to that purpose, because for us, our purpose is to have our honeymoon after quite some time, but we would like to have leisure and luxury in our travel. Next is where is to stay is linked to your purpose, because there are some quite affordable resorts also, but we're staying in one of the romantic destination, which is the Barros Maldives, because our purpose is to have leisure, luxury, and romantic, me and my wife. Check on first, when is the best season, what airline, what to do, and what is your purpose. And next is where to stay. And lastly, how to plan your vacation is based on all of those three things. So you may have itinerary for excursions, for travel, for how long will you stay. So those are the key things when doing the research. Quick tip number two, there are budget resorts out here. If you are on a tight budget, depending again to your purpose, you can first go to Maafushi Island, which is a local island to do your excursions or travels or whatever activities that you would like to do, because it's so much cheaper there, maybe half of the price than the private resorts. And then just take a day trip going to the private islands. There are some resorts that accepts day trip, and then you can check it with the Maafushi. I will not dwell on that much. Then next is, there are 3 to 4 star resorts which has meal plans. These are the half board, bed and breakfast, full board, and all inclusive. I will explain to you briefly one by one. First is bed and breakfast. So you just wake up in the morning, then you have a breakfast. Normally it's a breakfast buffet. Next is half board. So you have 2 meals a day, breakfast and dinner. Full board is you have 3 meals a day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. We had that when we were in Olhoveli. It's okay. And lastly is the all inclusive. All inclusive is just basically full board plus all of the drinks they have in their menu of all inclusive. Ranges from fruit juices, soft drinks, and some alcoholic beverages as well. So those are the difference from bed and breakfast to all inclusive. You may check the resort that you have chosen if they have the meal plans as well. Go check it out. Quick tip number three, you can book in 2 ways. First is by package, those online booking like maybe Agoda, Zuji, or whatever, or TripAdvisor, that can help you with booking the packages. There's pros because the overall cost lowers So it's a little bit cheaper than booking direct. Have more flexibility in your budget as well. And then the next one is booking direct. So that's what we chose. We booked direct through online website of Olubeli and also from Baros so that I can enjoy some additional benefits. For example, here in Baros, we got upgraded from just a simple deluxe villa, which is the lowest cost, to a beach pool villa. It's amazing. The deluxe villa don't have pool, much smaller, but the beach pool villa was big and have direct access to the beach and have your own pool. It's so private, it's so nice. That is one, I think, great advantage of booking direct. One more thing is that when we book direct through Baros, which you can again check the links down below, is that you will have free champagne on arrival. There is also early check-in. We check in at 10 a.m. That's early, way early. Because normal check-in in resorts is 2 p.m., right? But we checked in at 10 a.m. The room is ready. It's all nice and stuff. And also, you can have the late checkout option as well. And then, we also have a free sunset cruise courtesy of Baros. Quick tip number 4. Depending on your purpose, again, is stay in the Maldives for at least a week. Well, depends on your budget as well, because I can tell you, we are staying here for 6 nights in total. I think it's not enough. It's better to stay longer. You can also actually stay in a couple of resorts, just like what we did. We stayed in Olubeli for 2 nights, and then we stayed here in Baros Maldives for 4 nights, which is divided into two different villas, which is one is the upgraded beach pool villa, and then this one, the beautiful over the water pool villa with a direct sunset view. If you can stay for a week or more than a week, that's better. Tip number 5, just what I said, we are staying in over the water villa. If you are staying in the Maldives, stay in an over the water villa, because I assure you, your experience will be much, much better if you stay in a water pool villa. Because, actually, water villa in a sense, because that's what Maldives is. Lastly, I think, quick tip number 6 is you just need to enjoy it. Just let go of everything. Maldives is designed for you to relax, enjoy the scenery, and just feel the local Maldivian feeling. They are all nice here and all good. So just enjoy the travel, because out of all of the things, out of all the preparations that you made prior to your trip, is when you get there, be sure that you enjoy every single moment of it. Like, for me, I'm a photographer and videographer. So what I do is I do a vlog itself, I do a cinematic, whatever. But aside from those things, I do even time lapse it, that takes long time. But even if I do that, I still get to enjoy the feeling, because I'm happy. Like, God, this is great. This is what this life is. So again, thank you for watching. I hope I helped you. Again, I am by no means an expert, but I just want to share with you what we realized and what we experienced during our stay here in the Maldives. If you like this video, comment down below, hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, follow me on Instagram and Facebook as well. I am Josh Antolin. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye.